I did introduce myself. I'm Manasi Scott, for those of you who don't know me, and it gives me unique pleasure in welcoming you on behalf of Hindustan Unilever's Magnum Ice Creams and Farah Khan Fine Jewelry. Thank you so much for joining us here this afternoon. We're here to witness the confluence of unadulterated pleasure and flawless craftsmanship. Art and Magnum have a lot in common. They're both way better than therapy. Jokes aside, both stand for an expression of delight, an expression that actually touches all the senses. Because of this similarity, we're going to give you a taste of the finest craftsmanship at its best, inspired by Magnum. But before we read the entire book, let's take a look at a few chapters. Yeah, you can clap, we always love it, even if you're members of the press. Don't stop the applause at any point in time. Now that you know the definition, let's take our journey into high gear. Let's find out how Magnum brought a stellar craftsman for an experience that spells out the passion of the craft loud and clear. Magnum's partner in crime is a true connoisseur, one of India's finest jewelry designers, a favorite amongst celebrities, the inimitable Farah Khan. What she's done is something extremely special, tapping into the spirit of Magnum, the tastes of Magnum, the textures of Magnum, and the layers of Magnum to craft a unique, never seen before, limited edition collection. The results, my friends, is pieces of irresistible wearable art. We're going to hear it all about from the creator herself. First, I'm going to greet you and say hello.
What a beautiful song.
Thank you so much. There you go. So, appreciation all around and, pleasurable appreciation. One more time, ladies and gentlemen, Farah Khan. Would you like to share? Well, could we get a mic for Farah? Easier. Thank you. Thank you for being here with us, Farah.
The pleasure is all mine.
Is there anything you'd like to tell us at the start before we get into our Q&A about your journey with Magnum?
I just want to say that this collection and this collaboration was a totally pleasurable one for me. Because I truly take pleasure seriously, and I hope you love what I have created, because it's a lot of passion, a lot of love, and a lot of art. Thank you.
Perfectly said. Would you like to share your thoughts and ideas behind crafting a collection like this? I mean, bringing jewelry and Magnum together. What were you thinking when you did it?
Well, when Magnum came to me and we thought of doing something like this. What actually matched was the inherent commitment to craftsmanship that we both had, expert craftsmanship. And I would say it's a confluence between artistry and passion, and above all, pleasure. Because I took Magnum's richness, decadence of richness of colors and flavors, and being a chocolate lover myself, I got inspired and I put in, used, chocolate diamonds, caramel enameled, caramel flavored enamel in the jewelry. And I took the FKI of detailing and craftsmanship. And I would say I put together a state of art collection that had a lot of shimmer, shine, and sparkle. And one that the jewelry would remind you of being playful, and would you take pleasure seriously, because I'm very passionate about what I do, and I don't love to design, I live to design. So I actually lived this collection, and I'm so happy with the way it showed up.
I love that line, I don't love to design, I live to design. That's Farah Khan for you. Besides such an indulgent and pleasurable collection, you've also come up with extremely decadent names. Would you like to tell us something about how that came about? I love the names of all her pieces.
Well, when we designed this collection, it was very important for me to name the collection and name each of the pieces in the collection, because I wanted every jewelry piece to remind you of that bite of ice cream that you take when you enjoy Magnum ice cream. And so I named it. And the first one was the brooch. It's a beautiful chocolate enamel and chocolate diamond and white diamond brooch we've actually created with a bite of Magnum using the FK motif. I named it Luscious because it's very luscious when you look at it. The ring, which is two different flavors of Magnum ice cream, we named Bliss. And the necklace that I'm wearing, which has the Magnum motive on it, the M, and at the back you have an FK signature motive. I named Divine because that's how I feel when I eat chocolate ice cream. and the earrings I'm wearing also, I named them Tempt because I think everyone, each one of us is always tempted to eat ice cream. I don't know about all of you, but I'm definitely tempted. And so we decided that we'd have names which remind you of the pleasure you get when you bite into your favorite Magnum ice cream.
That's beautiful. And looking at those earrings, I don't know what I want to do more, wear them or bite into Magnum ice cream. It's all decadent and pleasurable, but you did have a muse for this entire collection, didn't you? Would you like to tell us about her?
So I had this idea in my head, and I said, now I need a muse, one who would wear it well, and someone who I would relate to. And I thought of Kalki, because Kalki is like chocolate, you know. She's very, very warm. She's very, very real. And you know, when I look at her, I just melt because she just makes me want to just give her a tight hug. And she's also very playful and someone who's beautiful inside out. So I want to thank Magnum for introducing me to Kalki in real life for this collection. When I met her, I actually behaved like I was starstruck. I went and said to her, I said, I love you. I just have to say I love you. And I think she was amused that someone like me just kept saying, I love you, I love you. But she really inspired me, and her journey in the movies and who she is as a person fits perfectly well with the tagline, takes pleasure seriously, because she's doing something she truly loves. And so is Magnum, and so am I. So I think it's a perfect fit.
Very well said. I'm just going to cut down my introduction because that's perfect. All right, then let's call upon a lady who truly personifies this one-of-a-kind collection. Please join me in welcoming the power icon for many Indian women, a theatre maven and a Magnum in the field, Kalki Coachlin. Very good, and so good to have you here on stage with us, and such a pleasure to see you adorn and pull off this jewelry, be her muse. But of course, taking pleasure seriously begins with Magnum. You have two Magnum women here, and we had a Magnum song as well. So let's get our Magnums onto stage.
I think we've had, how many ice creams this morning?
I think I've had about two or three.
Three.
Should we tell them about the shoot? I had 10 ice creams on one day, full ones.
Sugar high.
And yeah, I enjoyed it actually. I didn't complain. So I bit into 24 and ate 10.
You guys can carry on. I've got my hands full.
Oh, what will I talk with then?
The hair has to go. I'd say they've done well. I have.
One more? I mean, you want more of this? Because if you keep it long, you have
to eat the milk also.
Take a bite. You want us to take a bite? Okay, ready?
Here we go. Ready? Go.
Help them out with the chicks. The ice cream is just going to melt quite a bit, so let's just, we'll give you a lot of solo pictures later. So that's the phenomenal ice cream. This is the collection. I have to ask you, pleasure, seriously, or secret sins?
Secret sins? Well, I don't know why people associate pleasure with sin. I think,
which is why I gave you options.
No, I think that pleasure should be taken seriously and celebrated. And, you know, I think you can't take pleasure. You can't give pleasure if you don't take pleasure. So I think it's a very important part of life.
That's perfectly said, and kind of like our motto here this afternoon as well. But let's talk about the collection. How does it feel being Farah's muse and wearing that beautiful brooch and, of course, the other pieces in the collection?
Well, it's very flattering, and it's been amusing as well to like work with each other, because we've had these ice cream disasters and we've had a lot of fun just eating ice cream. And you know, I think Farah has a very, very exuding positive energy, and just like this music. That's a great ringtone, by the way, whoever's got that. I think I want to get that ringtone.
I'm just really glad that didn't happen in the middle of my song.
In the middle of your song. Yeah, that's true. But no, I think the collection is beautiful. I think it's exquisite. It's got a lot of subtlety to it. It's easy to wear, both evening wear and daytime. I like the fact that she's taken this playful element from Magnum of an ice cream and the enjoyment of ice cream into jewelry. It's been a pleasure to wear it.
Yeah, this is just the jewelry sounding as delicious as the ice cream right now.
Yes.
But which is your absolute favorite piece? Do you have one, and do you know the name?
Farah's wearing the earrings that I think are beautiful. They're called Tempt, and I think she could tempt anyone with those earrings.
Wow, they are beautiful. This is what I said. So finally, what is the one pleasure you take really, really seriously?
I really enjoy being on stage, and I think, you know, right now being on stage is great, but generally being in theatre, being on stage in front of a live audience is the moment I'm the most present. I'm very much in that present moment. I'm not thinking about anything else, and that for me is pleasure, to be in the moment.
And we are in the moment, as Kalki pointed out. There's a lot that goes into crafting a masterpiece, and Farah has managed to make us believe in the beauty of fine artistry. Here's a peek into their journey.
Without pleasure is a day lost. And we, you know, we talk for people and we talk to people who believe in the same philosophy. And that's why, you know, a Magnum, we say, is not made, it's not manufactured, it's really crafted. It's crafted with the best ingredients, it's crafted by the best chocolate chefs in the world. And, you know, and therefore we also then collaborate with people who believe in the same philosophy, and that's why we are here with Farah. She's one of the finest, you know, craftsman in her own field, and she takes, you know, her passion, her art, with the same sort of seriousness that we take our products with. So, you know, great to have this partnership, and great to have Kalki as the muse. I'm sure Farah's made a great choice there. Yeah. So, yeah, really happy to have all of us here. It's a sort of confluence of everything that Magnum and Farah stand for.
Confluence of a lot of craftsmanship and genius, I must say. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Farah Khan, Kalki Kochlan, and Himanshu Kanwar. As we celebrate pure craftsmanship while taking pleasure seriously, as you know.
Also, what a pleasure to hear you sing, Manasi. Yes. Always.
Thank you.
Beautiful.
Thank
amazing.
Thank you so much.
I want that song, by the way.
Lovely. I'm going to send you one. This has made my day. So I will go grab my Magnums backstage and indulge. The floor is open, ladies and gentlemen, now for you to ask your questions.
Guys, actually, I think Kalki has to leave. She has a flight to catch.
I have a flight to catch. So if you have any burning questions that are melting in your mouth, now is the time to ask them. And like, I'll take like two or three questions. Anybody? Photo khichna hai? Theek hai. Let's take some photos then. All right.
I'm coming there.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for being a part of this afternoon. So Kalki does have a flight to catch, but there are some questions that I'm sure Farah and Himanshu would be more than willing to answer. Unless you got, as Kalki said, a melting question for her. Thank you. Kalki, there's one question for you. Please go ahead, ask it quickly. Ask it. Who's on the mic, lady? Ask your question quickly.
Kalki, can you come down for a small common bite with all of us? Small.
A comment?
Common bite.
A common point?
Common bite?
Yes. I'm really sorry, but I'm going to miss my flight. I really can't.
Kalki, Gully Boy ki shoot almost khatam ho chuke. Kis tarah ki?
Haan ji,
khatam ho chuki hai. Kis tarah ki film hai aur kis tarah ka role hoga aapka?
It's about Dharavi slum rapping. Some of the boys like Divine, Nazy, Kambhari have written some amazing lyrics for the film. Of course, Ranveer Singh is playing a rapper. I'm playing a music producer who helps him with one of the songs. Yes, it's really fun. Alia Bhatt is also in the film and it'll be out early next year. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you so much.
Bye.
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Kalki Kochlin. So Farah's here, we'll share a mic. I love that pendant. About her, I'm really going to. So before your question answers, I would like to tell you that the entire collection will be up on stage and will be displayed. Any questions for Farah, you can ask me right now. Photos. So please take your solo shots. As I mentioned, the collection will be here on stage for you to view. Himanshu, thank you, but you must take some photos. And I think we should get you a Magnum as well in your hand. And I am the color of your dark Belgian chocolate today. Ladies and gentlemen, any questions right now? Otherwise, I'm going to say bye to them and continue with your photo ops. Are we good? Thank you, members of the press. It was wonderful to be here and be a part of this lovely event with you. I hope you've had a pleasurable afternoon. Manasi Scott signing off. Good day. Thank you, Himanshu. Please give it up for Farah Khan. Thank you, Himanshu. Bye-bye, ladies and gentlemen.